Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I'm Donna Jones, and this is Be You Say Bye. I'm excited about saying bye to the devil. I'm excited about putting my feet on his neck. I'm excited about kicking him to the curb. I'm excited. But you know, a lot of times I'm excited, but it's because I need to take care of me, because it's not always the devil. But you know what? I'm still putting him up under my feet so that he don't have no place in my life. So I'm excited about the Word of God. I'm excited about just being in the kingdom, and I'm excited about having a free life, in Jesus' name. And yes, I am looking around because I do have to get my cell phone, and I'm just having a good time looking around and thanking God for his goodness and his mercy. Because you know what? We can't make it without the Word. And before I get into the Word of God, I just want you to know about That's What She Said. And I am performing. I am part of That's What She Said, which is March the 2nd at the Virginia Theater at 7:30 p.m. I'm excited that you called the Virginia Theater Register, and I don't think that you have to give a name, but you already know I'm Donna Jones. Get a seat, because it's already filling up, and so get you a place to sit where you're comfortable, where you can cry, you can laugh, or you can just sit there and be a blessing to someone that has invited you. So I'm excited about this here. That's What She Said, presented by the Sterling Wealth Management. And you just come. March the 2nd. Call the Virginia Theater. God bless you. God bless you. I am excited about the Word of God. I know that last week, I could not find the title that I had been talking about, and Jesus warning and telling us to watch. But God blessed me to talk about something else. But I came today and I said, you know what, God, it's here. And I know that it's here. So I just started searching my Google, and there it was. And this one here is, watching means properly using your mind, being prepared. God said he didn't give us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. So I'm excited about having a sound mind. I'm excited that according to the Bible, this tells me God gave us a sound mind, a renewed mind, and I'm excited about that. So here it says, God gave us marvelous minds to use, to study, and to learn and observe and analyze, judge, and think. We have to think about things instead of rushing into things. We want to rush into things, and then we get in trouble. Hallelujah. But Romans 12 tells us we have a renewed mind in Christ, and so we have to take that time and stop rushing and meditate. I'm excited about fasting and praying about things where I know that God has already taken care of every need. He said, my God shall supply all of our needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. He's done all this 2,000 years ago. So what you do is you thanking. Stop asking, because he's already provided. But he did say in James, I think it's James chapter 2, that we have not because we ask not. But don't think that you're being greedy or you're being selfish. The Bible says you have not because you ask not. Tell God what it is you want. Because you know what? Life is time. To waste time is to waste life. And a lot of us do. I mean, as I'm saying, a lot of us just waste time. And then we want to know, oh, I can't do this. I didn't get to do that back in the day. Well, if you stop wasting time and wasting life, plan and search out, seek what it is that you want to do, and then begin to put it in order. That's what we don't do. And then we have to suffer the consequences because we haven't searched, we haven't seek, we haven't prayed about it. We didn't even ask God about it. But we go ask other people, how are they going to tell you what you can do and what you can't do? Talk to God. That's the thing that we tend to forget. We forget to talk to God. So I'm here to tell you, talk to God, amen? And it says here, to waste time is to waste life. And many people are mentally lazy. They want somebody else to do. There's a commercial, and the man says, well, do you know anybody that knows how to do this, 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 this? Well, I need this done, this, that. Because, see, he's being lazy. He don't want to go and look himself. He wants his neighbors to look it up and to go search. No, it's for you to go search. Search. A lot of people say, I'm lonesome. I'm tired. I don't want to. Get up and let God show you the best of the best. Because if anybody knows it, God does. Amen. And I'm excited about that. It says here, many people are mentally lazy, wasting a tragic amount of time on the trivial and temporal and mundane and materialistic things. Many squander countless hours vegetating in front of their TV, their computer, their cell phones, seeking only to be entertained. And I'm just going to talk about my husband. He stays on that gospel. He savors it, and he pulls in, and he chew on it, and he swallow it, and a lot of it is just like tasting just like honey. That's what the Bible said. Chew it up, see it tastes like honey, because that's what the Word does. The Word is so good, hallelujah, the Word is so good that you need to get out there and you need to find out just what God's talking about. Real readers are becoming very rare. A society becomes shallow and superficial when most citizens rely too much on pictures and images rather than words, rather than the Word of God. In-depth learning requires language. And I always tell you, you got to say something. Find out what God is trying to get to you. What is he trying to teach you? What is he trying to tell you which way to go? And there's a reason why. He wants you to go the right way. Hallelujah. And that's the reason why I tell people, righteousness is just doing it the right way. Well, how can you do it the right way if you don't seek and study and learn? Hallelujah. And it says here, it is quite sufficient that God's true religion is based on spoken and written messages that were compiled into what we call the Bible. A lot of people don't look at the Bible. They don't read the Bible. I do a class, and I really love the class. I love studying the Word. And then how God gives you the Word, and at first it sounds like, oh my God, this is so complicated, I can't really understand what's going on. But if you get in there and get in Google and look up them words and then put that stuff together, wow, oh my, you got a masterpiece. but we just don't get in there and study. And I tell my husband, how did you know that? He said, Donna, I studied. I looked it up, okay? And that's what we have to do. And I'm excited about that. I'm excited about the Bible. And in fact, it tells us God's people are to be people of the book. Now that sounds good, didn't it? I didn't come up with that. I wish I had it, but I didn't. Okay. I look good though, didn't I? Hey, I look real good. In contrast, most pagan religions emphasize images, idols, symbols, and rituals. That is not of God. You see, God wants his people to zealously get into the Word of God and read. People talk about they bored. Read the Bible. Get you a tablet. Write it out. Learn how to cipher it and study to think and meditate on the Word of God. He says, chew it up. Amen. Chew it up. And I'm telling you, it'll take you places you ain't never been. You'll learn things that you have never, ever heard of if you just get in the Bible. I tell everybody, start in the book of Psalms and the book of Proverbs. Those are my favorite books. The Psalms and Proverbs, because you know it tells me how to do things and what he said. He said, don't put your confidence in man. I like that. Because see, I want to seek for myself. I want to learn for myself. And then I want to go around hearing other people that God has spoken to. Woo! That spoken word. And they're putting it out there. And I told my husband the other day, I said, ooh, tape that. Because I wanted to hear that again. So, you see, God wants his people to zealously read and study, to think and to meditate. Meditate on the Word of God. And meditate don't mean silent prayer. Meditate means let your ear hear what you're saying. That's called meditation. And he wants us to be well informed. Amen. Well informed. Regarding the major geographical, cultural, spiritual issues and events of this time, 2019. You know, somebody said something the other day, and I had to tell him, yeah, I can even say it, old school. Hey, we were taught, what we learned is old school, it ain't working now. So you think in old school, you outdated. But you can train up a child in the way that they're supposed to go. And it seems like it's old school. But let me tell you, you can't go around hitting no kids now. You can't go around spanking no kids. But I tell you what, I can put them in timeout and take that cell phone. Oh, did I get carried away? I think I got carried away. Hey, what child is supposed to be going to bed at 10, 12 at night with a cell phone? Take that. Wait a minute. I got a good one for you. Are they paying rent? Are they paying the mortgage? Well, then you in control. You birthed them. They didn't birth you. Oh, did I say that out loud? I'm just telling you. We've got, God's word tells us that God deplores ignorance and indifferences and being dull of hearing. And that's in Hebrews 5 and 11. We act like our children birthed us. And I don't understand that. They don't have no job. And then they gonna tell me they're not going to school. Well, I remember a time, okay, I'm gonna go old school on y'all. My son told me when he graduated, he wasn't going to work. He wasn't going to school. So I said, oh, you're not gonna do any of those things? I took him to the Army. I signed him up. Because you're not going to sit around and not do something because you say for a whole. Oh, no, you got me twisted. Anyway, but he didn't like it. He did not like it. But he went to the Army. And I think that when your children are going to tell you what they're not going to do in your home, come on, you ain't got to do nothing. Just take them on over there to the Army. I bet you they'll get some training, and it won't hurt them. It won't hurt them. We think that somebody's going to hurt them. It's not going to hurt them to learn. It's not going to hurt them to get in order with themselves. This is where the Bible comes in, providing the essential framework for a godly worldview. The Bible is God's divine revelation of absolute truth. Hallelujah. And it says here, which is just as irrelevant today as it ever was 2,000 years ago. Come on now. The Bible does not change. God said he does not change. Whatever he said he's going to do, he done it. Hallelujah. And because of this, listen, you tend to say, oh, Miss Donna, that's so boring. But you're having a hard time relating. You're having a hard time relating to your children, to your husband, to your wife. You're having a hard time relating. And he talks about relationship. First of all, get a relationship with him, and marriage is a work. I mean, we go through changes. In fact, my husband think I know it all. No, I don't. But I feel like I know it all. You know, at this age, at 69, I feel like I know more than that 21-year-old. And she just cracks up when I say, what make you think you know more than me? Girl. But I love all my grandbabies, and I talk to them just like I'm talking to you. I tell them to listen to your mother and your father. Listen to grandma and grandpa, because we know just a tiny bit more than you. And guess where we got the understanding from and the wisdom? God. It wasn't hard. I love seeing my granddaughter come to church. She's so active. She's just running around the church, taking care of the children and helping her mama take care of the Sunday school children. And I mean, it's just amazing. And you never seen anything that's so pleasing to a grandparent, grandparents, and mamas and daddies, is to see your child running around the church, 3 years old, clapping and hitting the tambourine. That is the most glorious thing in the world. And trying to sing. Yes, yeah, she's 3 years old, trying to sing a song and get up there, up close to the choir and be singing them songs with the choir. That brings so much love and peace and joy to us. You need to see your children praising God. Hallelujah. And then it says, train them up in the way that they should go. I'm not saying that they're going to be perfect children, because, okay, anyway. But they'll have that mindset that Jesus can bring it back to their remembrance. And on, oh, do you remember when you were singing in the choir? Do you remember dancing in the church? Do you remember running around in the church and everybody's just saying, oh, isn't that cute? And listen, and because of this, Bible should be the prims, lens, and filter by which we can actually perceive and judge all other information. Get in that Bible and see what that Bible say about what you're about to do, Donna Jones. It enables us to develop a godly world view, the framework and foundation by which we can actually interpret it. All that is going on in the world, it's in the Bible. You thought you came up with what's up. It's in the Bible, okay? It's in the Bible. things that we think that we created with words. No, 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 no. Go to the Bible. You be cracking up. Let me tell you, it's in the Bible. Find it. You got a word, it's in the Bible. Hallelujah. And I'm excited about that. But it says here the framework and foundation by which we can actually interpret all that is going on in the world. We can then understand our confusion, world scene with amazing clarity, sense, and logic. Let me tell you, we think we're going through something that's new to the world, but there's nothing new under the sun. That's why you get in the Bible, you would just, like, dude, this is in the Bible. I didn't know this was in the Bible. See, I'm saying this because I want you to go and learn what God has created and how they have already gone through what we're going through. They just know how to handle it because they had Jesus. Well, we got Jesus on the inside. They was walking with Jesus, but we got him on the inside. Hallelujah. Jesus rebuked the Pharisees and the Sadducees for their hard-hearted mindset. Oh, I wasn't talking about y'all. I promise you I wasn't. But hard-hearted mindset. Back in the Pharisees and the Sadducees' time, it's going on right now. That's how God wants us to get lined up with the Word of God so he can teach us that we don't have to be hard-hearted. When you accept Jesus Christ of Nazareth, when you accept him into your life and you become a believer and you begin to receive the Word of God, hallelujah, and then you can stand on faith and his grace. Oh, unmerited grace, favor, favor, favor. It's right here. It says, if they had not had evil attitudes and had believed the scriptures by faith, they would have been able to discern the signs of the times and to realize the Messiah. Oh, Jesus. The Messiah has come. Matthew 16, 1 through 3. The Messiah is here. Jesus Christ died on the cross that you would have life and have it more abundantly. Abundance, riches, and wealth. All you have to do is reach up and grab it and pull it down. Reach up and grab what belongs to you. It's yours. You can't have nothing if you don't claim it. If I give you $100 and you don't take it, I'm putting it back in my pocket. I bless somebody else. Oh, that's all right, Sister Joan. I don't need it. Well, okay, you don't need it. I'll go pass it on and bless somebody else. You don't need it. Hallelujah. You don't need it, so I'll bless the next person. But that's what God says. Reach out. Take it. It's take it. I bet you the person next to you gonna take it. And you just missed out on God's blessings and promises. Because God tells us, he says, watch. Watch as well as pray. And you know what? What we don't do? We don't give him enough thanks. We don't thank him enough. We thank him in the church. Look, I thank him for a bed and a sheet and a pillow. I thank him for a face cloth. I thank him that my water came on this morning. I thank God that it didn't get so cold that the heat went out. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Carbon monoxide didn't go off in the house. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. That's what I'm grateful for. I'm grateful, I'm grateful, I'm grateful that God saw fit that I would be here, part of his plan and purpose, receiving all that he has for me. casting, getting rid of all these issues that I'm being attacked with. Amen. I'm here to tell you, we need knowledge of end time prophecy. We need the word of God. We got to look these words up. Okay, hello. We got to look these words up. Okay, I'm just telling y'all. This is going to be next week. We got to look all this up. Okay? But I'm grateful. I'm totally grateful about the word of God. I'm grateful that I was made in his image. He created me in his image. That's how come I keep telling y'all, I love me some me. I you know, 4 feet and 10 inches of fabulous. Hey, what's up? You know, you got to love on yourself. You got to get into the word and find out that if God loves you, then, and I love you, start hugging yourself and loving yourself. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, this is what it's all about. That's why I stay excited. I stay excited. I got issues. Sometimes I turn this way and sometimes I turn this way. But you know what? I know who loves me more than I love me. I know who loves me more than my husband loves me. I know my husband loves me. Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Jesus. And I'm having a ball. I just laugh with him. I talk to him. And sometimes I say, oh, I forgot to say thank you. And it's going on 10 o'clock at night. Oh, yeah, we get busy. But thank God for Jesus. Amen. Get busy and get into the word. Get busy and start saying thank you, Lord. I'm Donna Jones. And this is BU. Say bye. Amen.